walks further down the street. People way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip. To the sound of the beat, yeah.
Another one bites the dust.
Another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust, hey. Hey, gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
What?
I didn't think I'm gonna get along without you when you're gone. Took me for everything that I had and kicked me out of my own. I am happy, I'm satisfied, all I can is stand to hit. I didn't die when I'm gonna try to see the sound of me. Look out! Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust.
What up, bro? What's gonna be? Hello, Nikki.
I know I'm gone.
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
Yeah.
The triumphant return. Better. Feeling better here.
Triumphant return, that's right.
Had a pretty good day today, bro. Not bad, not bad.
Good for you, brother. Good for you. Should we go live?
Oh, wait, I thought we were already.
We are. Oh my God!
Hell yeah, Timothy.
Good job. That and it excited Abby. She heard that.
Hello to Sabrina Carmichael. That somebody new. I'm not familiar with Sabrina, I don't think.
Oh yeah, she's been over there with me and Tokamay.
Oh.
On Tuesday, every other Tuesday.
Good to meet you.
on the Hillbilly Hangout or something, whatever there they is. Call it. I'm
not sure. Texas Dave.
And Maya, where's Maya?
Good evening. Oh, she's here.
Good evening.
No.
Nope.
Sounded like Bella's a girl. Good evening. Good evening.
She's like, wait a minute, Pops is streaming. I got to get on the camera.
Hey, Sabrina. Hey, Timothy Olsen. Caleb Reynolds in the house. We have Nikki in the house. Good to have some female representation in here. And Shadow Hawk and myself and Texas Dave. Yeah, we got to keep that momentum going. You know, we got to keep that momentum going.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, we got to drive it up. You know, we got to get it going. I'm glad you're feeling better, Shadow Hawk.
Well, thank you. I am too. I was sick of being sick.
I bet you were. I bet you were. We all hate that.
Oh, man. Yeah, it was a rough weekend, and yesterday was none too pleasant, but today's much better. That one might get you. I don't know, right?
You remember this one, Dave?
I sure do.
Superstar.
Sounds like me in the morning, Dave.
I like the whole
song. This is Thomas Dolby, right?
Huh?
Was that Thomas Dolby?
She's here.
No, sir. That was not Thomas Dose. What you said, Dolby. It was Sailieri mix. Let's see. Falco.
I'm thinking. Yeah. I was thinking of the other, the Weird Science song.
Science, yeah, she blinded me with science.
Ooh. I think, yeah, that one's the right. Thomas
that
Dolby.
Was Thomas Dolby did that.
She okay, blinded yeah, me. That was what Maya. I was thinking of.
Maya was right there in the camera, and then she was like,
blinded me with her tail.
I think she's camera shy. She's just disappeared on me.
Yeah, Falco. There we go, Falco.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to just say, Rex, that Kerry very kindly sent me that money across for the postage, by the way, last week.
And we appreciate that.
Sweetheart.
That was very kind of her because she didn't have to do it, you know.
And
I have to say, Kerry, you're a sweetheart. And where the hell are you? Why aren't you in chat today?
she'll skirt in here late. You wait.
Yeah,
She'll be in a little while because I sent her one or two photographs of Maya last week as well on Messenger, you know.
Oh, that's awesome.
So she sent me one of her cat as well.
Big news, Dave. You'll be getting the exclusive promo card here with Bystander.
Ooh, very nice.
Like that, and then you'll also be getting. I added it today. You'll be getting this nice little ditty with him all armored up.
Yeah, that's a bad one right there. Like it,
right? And yet, no one's taking me up on my offer except you and another person, Shadow Hawk. What up? Can't even get a dollar.
I don't know. We got to get that message out there somehow.
Well, I don't know what else I could do. I'm sure.
I know. I don't know. You know what? I've got another. I've got a monthly membership message I can use on Trashcast tonight. So I'll blast it out there tonight. You got to send me on Instagram the link to fund my comic, though, because every time I try to copy it, it doesn't work for me. I don't know why.
Well, so, you know, maybe. I put it down in the description when I made the announcement, and Passmaster Dan was saying the links aren't any good. But then when I would go over to where I got them, they would be good. And clicked on them. That, and I had mine and Hockey's Hockey sign up, because he contacted me and said, we're about a month off from launching Curiosity and Oddities. Mm-hmm. And I would like to come on the show. And I'm like,
cool.
Awesome. So
love Hockey.
Yes. Hockey did a 2-page story for me, as you know, 2 years ago of Dirty Joe, the introduction to Dirty Joe. I don't know if it'll still be the introduction to Dirty Joe, because.
But anyway, Rex, try shooting me the FMC link over on Instagram. So that way I can try to copy it from my Instagram.
Just the general campaign link. I mean, to all the projects?
No, for your project. For
my project. Well, that's an easy one. That's an easy
one. Yes. That way I can copy it finally, and then I'll use it in my message tonight on Ethan's stream. So that's probably about 3,000 people that will be watching.
Oh, crap. Oh, yeah. Good. I'll be over on topic list probably then. No one's taking me up on my offer. I guess they're not. They think. That's fine. I mean, Shadowhawk likes the ultra collectability. We're getting so close to.
Hell yeah.
I mean, you know, if nobody contributes a dollar, they're going to say, well, I backed you from day one. Well, I'm sorry to get this. You got to jump through some hoops. And actually, I upped the game and said, okay, if I can't get a backer for that card there, then I'll give them that card and this one. Because, you know, it was always the plan to do two promo cards per campaign, because that's what we did on the Ashcan, remember? We did do a promo trading cards.
Yep.
I mean, we've already unlocked the Devil Flyer card here. We're getting close to
the John Fernandez. Very nice.
Rob Ewing's Zigzag.
Yeah, I want that magnet, dude. Come on, people. Let's get this magnet.
It's going to be a longer magnet, too, than last time, I think. It does not need to be reduced that much. It needs to be a long,
well, you know, magnet. I think what you could do is, remember you cut your other ones in half? Because they printed them separate. You could probably just leave it whole, you know, and leave it as one.
Still too small. Still too small. It needs to be.
Really? Wow. Man, you're thinking big, brother.
I am. He needs some. He needs some breathing room. This is our mascot, by the way.
All righty. I'm all for it, man. I would be perfectly happy with. All right, let's show the people what I'm talking about. Because this, if you left it in one piece, this is a pretty good. So,
it would be business size card. Magnet. It would be business card. Hey, Belmont. Good to see you, Justin Belmont, in the house. He has a new Keshi figure, a red, my favorite color. Red is my favorite color. Yeah. So if you put them side by side, they're business card, but it needs to be bigger than that.
Yeah,
the magnet.
There's my hand. That's a pretty good size magnet.
Yeah, and they're thick.
Well, I got long fingers, but
yeah.
I mean, that's. The size feel of my like
long fingers.
We can't see you.
Yeah, it helps with playing
baseball. There you go. Whoa! My God, it's Anthropod. I've been watching The Invaders in color. A Quinn Martin production. Yeah, the mutated phalange there. It was like high tea for some of those aliens all day long. You know, the fingers they up were the only, air, right?
They were only
playing. Whoa! I'm not going to highlight that, Justin. Something about
the it. Hail, Belmont.
Okay. All right. More than we needed to know. Okay.
Child Green, howdy, howdy.
Yeah, I'm not in it, and hold on. That's all I can say. Have you signed up for a damn dirty thing yet? I have. He's getting ready to launch. I don't know. I haven't talked to Doc about. He said the end of March. It's getting to the end of March, folks.
There's Carrie. Hey, Gary.
Welcome to episode 698 of the 4 o'clock shadow, as you know.
Come on.
Hopefully. Glad to get Sabrina in here finally. There is Gary. Yeah, shut up, Jolly. Caleb says.
Okay, Gary, I will have to once we're done with the stream here.
Check your Insta. Okay. So Mom Hawk sees. Okay.
What you doing?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't think you could do better than two promo cards in color, Rex Christian production. And, you know, we may add some digital color to this. I had always envisioned him. Zigzag's an older character from 1993, created around the same time as the Momentum Comics. The Momentum Comics logo that you see with the with the bomb. This is a redo. This was from a couple years ago. John redid a similar logo to what he did in 93. He could not find his original, but his original one that he did for me back in 93 for Momentum Comics had a fuse bomb like this. And so we couldn't find the original. He did this.
Mama's not here right now, Carrie. She won't be home until 7:30, 8 o'clock. So I'll show it to her when she gets home.
Look at this wonderful content page that John Diller did for the book. I mean, this is going to be on the inside back cover.
Dude, that is so cool. I love that idea.
He draws a mean typer. Well, with John, you have to reuse the artwork. It's like so beautiful. You want to reuse it. So you'll be seeing this again, in a content. But I have another one of an old brownstone building I would like him to do with a zigzag patterned fire escape.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
That I would think would be a cool content page as well. But now with the zigzag magnet, I had originally in 1993 created him to be a red character. Hence, the red and black for the company, right?
Oh, right. Red's your favorite color, right? So
red's kind of like Flash, but I didn't mind that because it's not Flash. I don't know. Sometime last year, I said, you know what? He needs to be like streaking like light. So with digital, you could probably make him look pretty dope and white.
Yeah,
maybe an all-white character.
A hint of blue or gold or something, peeking around the edges.
No, what I'm thinking is he's glowing white, and maybe in his wake, in his slipstream, could be a little bit of red.
Ooh, okay.
Work the red in there a little bit.
There you go.
I like Rob having... like him breaking the sound barrier or something going on. It's almost like he's opening up a portal to run through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's cool.
I'll have to ask him. I've never asked him, what is that? Almost looks like a shield, doesn't it?
Yeah, I kind of just assumed that it was like a representation of the sound barrier, but I mean, what happens when you assume, right?
It's pretty cool when, who broke the sound barrier? Chuck Yeager, yeah. It's pretty neat when you break that sound barrier visually, the stream, almost like the slipstream when you're high up in the cold regions of the sky, really high up, where it kind of surrounds the vessel, with these streams of vapor. It's pretty neat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, actually, the sound you hear from a bullwhip is the sound barrier being broken. That crack.
Oh, bullwhip. He said bullwhip. Sorry about that. Doc has estimated April for release is what I last heard. Okay. I can send it to Rex if he chose Mama Hawk backstage before he shares.
He can send it with the Easter Bunny.
I don't know.
No, Easter's next Sunday, right? Shoot, never mind.
Yeah, it's this weekend, Shadow.
Yeah, it's coming up fast. It snuck up on me this year. Hey, what's up, Els?
How's everything going?
Good.
It looks like golf day. It looks like golf day with that hat.
Golf day, yeah.
Yeah.
Last time I saw a hat like that, it came with a free bowl of soup. Oh, but it looks good on
you. Is there any special significance to the hat? Like it was your grandfather's or no? Not at all.
It's similar to what my grandfather would wear, but it's not.
Now you've moved your camera a little bit more, and we can see that great DC Jim Lee artwork Superman box where the Walmart 100 pagers came in.
Ooh, fancy.
Up there on the shelf?
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's,
yeah, I like that's, those boxes.
And I do too. I never got a second issue box. They changed the configuration, but I'd love to have one. I've got three of them just like that.
Finally started putting stickers "Do not remove" because
they did. I peeled them off and walked out of the store with them anyway, full of comics.
Bad person. Yeah. But you'd pay for the comics.
Bam! And now for a Maya moment. Look at her breathing. Oh. Look at her breathing.
She's such a cutie. Got a beautiful pattern on her coat.
Yeah, she does. Yeah. Well, John, you're biased. I mean, Texas Dave, you are biased.
Well, I guess I am.
But as we say in the South, you ain't wrong. Wow,
just because you're bad, that will make you wrong.
Whoa, who'd we lose? Oh, I think John. Why do you, John?
I don't know why you keep wanting to call me John.
Okay, well, I'm sorry. I don't know.
He sounds a bit like John Lennon.
I think that's one thing I've never done is call myself another name, but I can't confirm that.
Hmm.
I probably have. I probably got my own name wrong. I remember once I was in fifth grade and I forgot my name. I think it was a blood sugar thing. I really do. There was a new kid, a beautiful young girl. She wasn't there very long, but I was trying to introduce myself and I can remember my own name.
Yeah. It's all your blood was in
you would think you'd never have a mental block. It wasn't that I was so enamored, although she was very beautiful, but I just could not remember my own name. At the moment, that's kind of disconcerting when you can't remember your own name.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah, the blood was just rushing the wrong way.
I know when I went for my yearly checkup, they asked me my name and date of birth right off the bat as you're walking in and your address. I mean, 20 questions. I thought, what the hell? Is it Jeopardy around here?
Well, talk about crazy, dude. When I was 55 a couple of years ago, I walked around the whole year thinking I was 56 already. I was like, I'm going to be 57 on my birthday. And my wife said, no, you're not. You're only going to be 56. I'm like,
well, hell, Shadowhawk, you had me convinced I was already 58 when I wasn't.
I don't
remember.
Now, how did I manage that trip?
But do you remember that?
I remember it. I just don't remember how I convinced
you. I just wrote it down and did the math. He had me convinced I was like 58 already, and I was 57 at the time. But now I'm 58.
Well, you swore you were 2 years older than me, and I thought I was 56 at the time. I wasn't 56.
I'm almost out of my 50s. I'm almost hitting 60, Elsie. My God, I'm right behind you.
I'm not telling you what I'm hitting then. Next.
I'll be hitting
70. 70? Yeah.
I got
how old are you, Dave? 69?
69 at the minute, right?
Ooh, good number. 69. I'm going to live it up when I'm 69, if I'm still alive.
2 years on Texas. 2 years on Texas.
If I make it to 69, I'm just going to turn around.
Yeah. Believe you me, I stopped counting when I got to 50.
I said, I can't count that high, brother. So,
Well, take your shoes off.
See how many people caught that one.
I just use the cat's paws if I get stuck for fingers to count.
There you go. And I know you have your dog, Elsie. You can start counting those lick paws, those raw lick paws.
I have a fit now for what I'm counting.
By the way, Rex, I was just going to say a couple of quick things while I remember.
Okay.
I hope Pops is slowly on the mend, because I know he's not been so good, has he, over the last few days?
Right. Now,
Say again?
Have you been going over there on Pops' channel?
I've not been on since he's, I think he came out of hospital, was it yesterday or the day before?
I think it might have been yesterday.
Yeah.
Well, having a hernia is not fun.
No.
Yeah, and from what he said, I saw a little thing. Shoot, I'm gonna have to pop out and come back in. You don't hear it?
I don't. Now let me mute Elsie and let's see if you're ticky. See, I don't hear you. It's the little tick is coming from Elsie.
Oh, okay.
I didn't hear him talking. Did you hear him, Texas?
I don't know if even the chat can hear it. I hear it, and I just assume it's me.
So. Yeah, he sounds good to me.
Yeah, you sound all right to me as well.
I'll let you know when you can go, Shadowhawk.
Anyway, okay. You've been gone long enough,
and we have Janet from another planet. Live long and prosper, dear.
And then the other thing is...
If you want to know anything Star Trek, Texas Dave, just go over to Janet from Another Planet. So, But does she know her who? Right, her Doctor Who.
And also, Rex, I was going to say, it was on the news about that bridge in America that got hit by that boat.
Oh, yeah, did you see that, Dave? That's crazy.
Yeah, I saw it earlier on.
I've not seen it, but I heard of it very, very, very early in the morning. Very early.
Dude, that thing came down like it was made out of Legos or something. It's crazy.
I couldn't believe how fast it just dropped, you know, with the.
I know. It was like, I mean, yeah, granted, it was a huge container ship that hit it. But
well,
thing just fall apart that quickly was just insane. It was, and the whole harbor was all lit up, so it was like daytime. It was like you were watching it.
Yeah.
At the very last moment, the Mayday came through. The boat was able to get a Mayday off, and if you watch the footage, the right footage, maybe security footage, I don't know what footage you're talking about, you'll see the car stop abruptly. And not go on the bridge. So they did save potentially a bunch of lives by doing that. Because there was, about 7 cars go in the...
Yeah, I think they said most of those cars were actually workers that were there doing
construction workers, working on the bridge. Yeah.
Last I heard on my way home from work, just 40 minutes ago, they had recovered 2 bodies, and there were still, I think, 5 or 6 people missing that they know of. And they still weren't sure how many cars. They believe the one big rig, an 18-wheeler, went in, and they're not sure if any passenger cars went in.
Janet, we're going to have to get you on the channel. I interviewed Janet over there on Apex's channel. I think she was on our Rex Hex and Apex show, Elsie was last Saturday and just a few days ago on his birthday. And Rich was on with us, although his internet went out. How was the storm for you last night, Elsie?
Other than my awning get blown off, everything's good.
Right.
Oh, dude.
That's pretty severe wind. I know we got severe wind, and that was the worst part of it. Got a bunch of rain, no thunder, no lightning. I was really surprised. Of course, I didn't stick my head out in the rain to see if it was lightning, but I'd heard no thunder. Didn't see any flashes. See what I did there? Should they read
my flash board? Dude, I almost got took out by it. By a tree branch this morning on my way to work.
It is cold here today, Janet says. Yes, we need to get Janet on this channel. It was nice to have her over on Apex's channel for the Rex X and Apex, or maybe it was X Allen. I don't know. She was our very special guest, and she's still coming around this channel. And I'm still subscribed to her. I try and I don't know everybody's scheduled. I am subscribed to a lot of people, but I love to go in there and hear about Star Trek. And I did go binge watch all the three seasons of the original Star Trek. So, and she's been covering that classic stuff, and I'm up on it, you know. So I enjoy the content.
Have you seen that Star Trek Continues on YouTube, Rex?
Yes, yes. That, in fact, Dave, that was one of the first things that I watched when I came on YouTube. That's got Vic Mignogna. No, that's not his last name. What is Vic's last name? The animator's voice, Shadowhawk. Vic, you know, he was canceled. It was big news.
That was Vic Mignogna.
Oh, now on Sundays. Okay. And if you want to drop your link to it, Janet, drop your link. You have a wrench. Please drop your link. You'll get some subscribers. If you love Star Trek content, I'm sure they do. I'm sure she probably has other stuff out there, too. I hope your family's doing well, Janet. Star Trek Continues was awesome. Absolutely, because it took me a little while to get into it because it wasn't Scotty, but it was Scotty's son.
Yes, it was.
And, you know the Romulan, the female Romulan that sparked with Spock. Say that 10 times. Spark with Spock. There we go. Carrie, quick draw, Carrie. Pew, pew, pew. Go over and check out Janet's. She has great content, lots of videos to watch. You won't regret it. She's a wonderful person. We really need to get her back on here. I am on Twitter. I'm on Instagram. Hit me up. I'm under Rex Christian on Facebook. Yeah, everybody's going to get this campaign sticker, the 6 a.m. sticker. And if you knew, it's over a year in the making for this sticker. He said, I'm unavailable, busy. And most people use this as a stretch go. I'm just giving it to everybody for free. But now, if you've already backed Devil Flyer, you can get 2 trading cards for $1. Just donate $1 to the campaign. And you can get only 2 people have hit me up on that. Only 2 people, and Shadowhawk's one of them. I don't know what's wrong with you. You can get this card right here, a bystander shadow reality type promo card in full color. And you can get this armored up Devil Flyer villain, or maybe that's Devil Flyer himself.
And you know what? Well, instead of just giving $1, go ahead and buy Abby a doggy meal for $2. Be a man.
That's absolutely right. I'm down to 3 doggy meals. I'm going to have to go to the store and get her some more in about 3 days. And I don't wait until last
month. I think I bought her another one the other night, Rex. Along with the John Fernandez cover.
Well, let's take a look and see what we are up on the count of the... on the Abby tier. Thank you, everyone. 7 backers.
The Abalusa.
I think it's been sitting at 7. I don't think you did. Maybe it was the last time you backed it, because you backed it at least once, I know.
So, Rex, you'll have to have a Maya tier as well, then.
But we are down to the last week, folks. We are down to the last 7 days of the campaign, folks. We ain't moving.
Got to get this baby rolling.
Rock 1756, Salzburg, January 27th. Wolfgang Amadeus is born.
I love that they give a recount of what we know about Amadeus in there. It's very informative, let's say, about his life. There's not really a lot known about Amadeus.
It was an interesting choice as an intro on that, I think, you know? I don't know.
You think so? Yeah. Well, I played it the other day. And people were coming in and going, "You're going to get struck. You're going to get struck. You're going to get struck." And it's like, no, I played these songs multiple times. I think they're safe. You know. And on that one, I didn't. I know. But I Shadowhawk was sick. I knew he would take over on his channel. I just shared your link to your campaign on my ex. Thank you for that. I've been sharing it out. I back to Abby twice, Carrie says. I love animals.
Yeah, I backed Abby at least twice so far.
I'll have to go back and watch those. Janet from another planet. Woo! And what planet would that be if you're not on Earth?
She's a Plutonian. Oh, wait, that's not a planet anymore.
Actually, Pluto's probably my favorite planet, and they showed some pictures of Pluto, and it's actually pretty colorful.
It's a rock.
Did they make it a planet again, or is it still being pissed
yeah,
on?
That was downgraded. That went Limp Bizkit on that one. Janet says...
That's horrible. Poor little Pluto.
We reviewed Star Trek Continues. I'll have to go back and watch those. Maya is still in the show. Look at her cuteness. I can fix that. There. How about that? We've got three great panelists. Well, you know, me excluded. We got two, my co-host and Elsie. What else you want? And Maya's still in the show.
Hey, she's the cutest out of all of us.
I take that personal, but anyway, you're probably right. Look at that. I just love that she likes to be like Abby does. You know, she'll sit in my lap in the recliner, and sometimes she can't get close enough, and sometimes she'll keep her distance, you know, but most of the time she's like right there, like Maya is just pawing, playing around, whatever.
Well, my cat is.
Okay, I love animals more than people. So you're a furry lover. Got it.
Hey, I like most animals better than most people as well. So at least animals you can trust.
She breathes hard. Now, how did you say Maya was?
What's that? Okay. What's that?
How old is Maya?
She's be coming up for about 9 in a few months' time.
9, okay. Mm. Number 9.
9.
So she's 9. German. Got it.
9.
My little one just turned 10.
No, Rex. I said animals, not people dressed like them. We don't get to see Abby despite hints. I've tried to get her to jump up in my lap, as you know, several times. Unless I'm drawing. Oh, she's younger than Shadow. He's 10 this year. No, he's not a leap year baby.
Cloudy's 10 as well. She just turned 10.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, it's hard to believe, man. She's still just a tiny little thing. It's like, wow, you know.
You know, Texas Dave, with my vast collection, your vast collection, Elsie's vast collection, and frankly, Shadowhawk's vast collection, we ought to have like a super show off, you know, of stuff. I mean, you could tell.
Yeah, man, we'd have to do like a 24-hour marathon.
But we're going to have to do it quickly because I'll probably have to go back to work at some point, you know.
Yeah,
Shadow is fat like a chunk.
What's that?
I am not. How dare you?
How dare you? Why is your cam not on, mister?
I am leaving wiry.
I think that's you, Rex, isn't it?
Oh, I know. I know. I knew that would be an irritant to carry. Where does she get that you're fat? You're skinny.
She's talking about she's talking about her cat, Rex.
His name is Shadow.
Yeah.
Well, that's confusing on the 4 o'clock Shadow. Don't bring that clapper in here.
Nobody else is confused but you.
Yeah, I'm not confused at all.
That's a given. Yeah. If you've not went up, I mean, you know, this is getting ready to launch. If you've not signed up for it, you're going to miss out. Doc Blaylock's pride and joy. You can see more of Doc's work over on Devil Flyer. He's extensively got original artwork up there for sale of my characters.
Doc is pulling what little of his hair he has out right now.
I think he did the best story back in 2022, which was the first story we worked on. The first Bog story. Elsie bought the... bought the first page out of it, so I no longer have all of it. I do have that in there. I do have a Sergeant Rock piece for you I can send to you if you want it, Elsie. I have that now, so I can stick it, you know, in that same card holder.
Oh, you can stick it. All right.
Top loader. Oh, I know. Carrie's already let me know that today. Stick it, Rex. Well, Doc has many art of the pride in comics and fine art. Yes.
We'll have incense to the comic gods.
Signed up, just waiting for him to launch. I know, Elsie, how do you put up with Rex's sass behavior?
Hey, he is who he is. Yeah.
Wait a minute. I just thought about that. I already got Doc's blacklight tapestries from the other campaign. What's he going to do for this one?
Oh, cool.
Interesting.
Very interesting.
Maybe what was your question, Shadowhawk? I missed that. I was actually reading Carrie's snarky
comment. Said I got both of the blacklight tapestries from Doc's first campaign. For Pariah.
Right.
So I already got the Golem and what's the girl's name? Anna? Is it? No, it's not Anna. Damn, I can't remember her name right now.
What? But anyway, I think you're thinking of the one from Doc Gift's book, right? Hunting Alice or something? Didn't he do one of those?
No, that hasn't come out yet, dude.
Okay. And Bog, of course, you bought Bog's tapestry.
Right. So I got Bog coming out.
I'm surprised.
I'm wondering what Doc is going to do, if he's going to do a tapestry for Damn Dirty Thing. I'm trying to figure out.
Doc said on Pariah Blood and Mud. Now, he probably had that offered up immediately on the campaign. I didn't. I had it offered up in a bundle. I've sold two tapestries so far.
Yep. Cool. One of them's mine.
One of them's yours. Yeah. And the only reason I had put that up there was Doc said he wanted one. So get with it, Doc, and buy a tapestry. He says read his book. I don't know that he's backed my book yet. We got to keep that $100,000 circulating around between us, folks.
Yeah,
you share the love with Rex.
I've done my part, man. My portion is gone. So,
so positive.
I did what I could last week. And that was a struggle.
You know. I guess I'm just gonna have to do a plushie for these girls to buy a Bog plushie or a Devil Flyer plushie.
Oh, dude, a Bog plushie would be cool. I'd even buy one of those.
Or a wrestling buddy type thing.
Yeah, slam buddies are all right, I guess.
Yeah, he does. He does. Yep. And I comp my artist. If you work on my book, you get comp. I think that's wrong. If you work on a book and maybe do the cover and you don't get a copy of the book, I'm even going to send one to Mike Barron, you know, because he gets sent stuff and reads, and I want his honest opinion. What do you think about my first full outage in the comics?
Ouch. May not go quite the way you want it to, Rex. I don't know.
It may not. I may be devastated. I've
been writing for a long time, dude.
Then that will be so long. 4 o'clock shadow. It was a good run.
I don't see that happening. I'm just saying.
I've got a very.
It may be a little rougher than you think it would. Just only because Mike has got so much experience. You know what I'm saying?
You know what? With this book, I should give him a red pen, 2 copies, so he can really mark one up. We'll do a show,
dude. Then you can turn around and sell that bad boy on eBay.
Oh yeah, well, Mike doesn't need the money, so.
No, but hey, share the wealth.
That's right. Well, I mean, that's another way.
Do a guy solid there, Mike. Yeah. I'll split it with you.
Well, you know, I'm really shocked. I mean, that's one reason I don't want to come on camera ever again.
Oh, right. You don't mean that.
What happened?
Hmm? He's shocked.
Dave thinks he knows me so well. So well. When I dig my heels in, I dig in. Yeah, you may never see my mug on camera again. Albeit you did a moment ago with my cowboy hat. So I was on camera, Carrie. Don't hate on me too bad. Carrie says, I don't think you realize, Dave, I paid shipping plus a little extra when you have our copies, we control Rex.
I think I did.
Okay. Well, I live under a bridge. I'll be a troll, sure. With barnacles, some of those clicky barnacles on me.
Wait a minute. Who the hell is Mike?
I don't know. I think that's the thing I'm speaking through right now.
What are you doing?
Okay, I missed something.
Yeah. Well, I have too. But I can't believe that Shadowhawk, you and another person are the only one that have taken me up really on the donate a dollar thing. Trading cards with his
artwork. I might just do another $5 and get another 10 cards. You know.
No, it doesn't work.
Why not?
No.
It might for you because you're my co-host, but we can't talk about that. Okay.
Don't you fuck with me, mister.
I'll send you some extras.
You know how many of those cards you're going to have to print? You might as well sell them to me.
Oh, no. I can actually number print those. I know I can.
Oh, really? You can do those too?
Yep. See, I've already done promo card 1 and 2 on the first campaign.
Damn it. I thought I had them over a barrel.
No. Maybe Niagara Falls. You said about mailing to Mike. Oh, Mike Barron. Yeah, suggested you do that only if he helps promote your campaign. Well, I mean, he's going to share my link on his Twitter. So there you go. That's helping promote it.
Carrie, Mike is helping just by being on the channel. I mean, frankly.
Absolutely. And
so are you, Carrie.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Thank you, Caleb, for the link.
I love Carrie. I don't know, you know, Carrie's in England, so she may not realize the weight of Mike Barron's name carries.
I think of a prehistoric knuckle dragger,
he puts Texas up there.
There he is with his saber-toothed cat. No, Dave's a civilized man. He's from Texas. I mean,
not really.
He's from Scotland. Originally.
That's right.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
It's Elsie, Dave Gar.
Texas Dave is Scottish. Originally. That's cool. Yeah.
Ooh. What you got, bro?
Don't you see that?
That looks like Destination Moon.
Yeah.
Oh, it's cool.
It's an artist in interpretation.
Well, I swear that's out of Destination Moon.
Hang on.
The movie that came out in the early 50s. Because
sit there and be wrong and you're wrong.
The rockets and that's from Destination Moon, the movie.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah. Yep. That was a big movie. That was a big sci-fi movie early on. Even though you look at it today and it looks very dated and wrong. Yeah.
Oh, I understand that, Kerry. But yeah, I mean, the guy's name carries a lot of weight here in the States. As well as internationally. I'm sure Dave is well aware of Mike.
Oh, there's few people that have written more comics than Mike Baron. Maybe Chuck Dixon, like he said, you know.
Maybe. But I like Mike's stuff better than Chuck's, actually. So
yeah, I do too. Is that bad to say out loud?
I don't know, maybe.
Thunderbirds. Maybe.
You know what, though? I mean, I'm friends with Graham, and I know Graham and Chuck worked together for a long time, but, you know, I mean,
it's just what
I think Graham knows I like Mike Baron better than Chuck.
Now Carrie's going to like that, because Harley Quinn is her favorite character. Yep. That's neat. I've not seen. Are those the books that you framed?
Dave? Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Both. How did you get that idea? How did you get that idea to do that? You just thought I had these two books, and
it just popped into my head, Rex, and I thought they'd be nice side by side in a frame.
You know what connects it really well is that they're both checker top covers.
Yeah.
So it just goes right straight across there. That's kind of nice.
Yeah, I did that with a Vengeance of Vampirella. They had a special blue foil edition of the 25th anniversary.
Well, yeah, like,
so I just folded it in half and then framed it and pressed it in there.
Right.
So
I mean, some of the covers are really worth framing, especially when you get two of the same or similar.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Side by side, you know.
Yeah, that was really nice, Dave.
Well, Shad Hawk, you remember that Image United? They had a Lincoln cover that was, I don't know how many covers. I've got six of them, but all interlinked. Showing all the Image characters.
They had that huge wall poster, too. You remember that? It was like a scroll, man. It was like
X-Men cover. X-Men number one, that Lincoln X-Men cover by Jim Lee.
Yeah, that thing was huge.
Sold 6 million. I think there were five of those, weren't there?
Four.
No, five.
I believe it was four.
Five.
Okay.
I'll die on that hill. Well, I don't know. I'm now.
You, it,
now
you,
there's a writer.
Doubting himself.
Well, that's part of your childhood, Dave. Thunderbirds. It's not really a part of my childhood. Doctor Who really wasn't part of my childhood per se. Early childhood.
Yeah.
Thunderbirds. Well, they were over here. I used to see them on PBS. I thought
PBS,
they were pretty cool.
Yeah. Well, that's where you would see Doctor Who too. And if they did play Thunderbirds, it was probably on PBS.
Exactly.
With our public donation. PBS.
Public broadcast
funded by the government by the tune of like $50 million a year, which it's kind of like the BBC. It's publicly funded. They have telethons and giveaway things, and
you're probably aware of
all that.
But you think about $50 million a year for television production, dude, that's nothing. That's a drop in the bucket.
Just through merch of Sesame Street, they could make that money. I don't
know. No, they can't, though, because that's Jim Henson's. They can't do that. Not without permission.
Yeah, but
that's
why
they always have the tote bag and the horrible coffee mug. Donate $250.
Is Sesame Street still going, or is Sesame Street still airing, right, since 1969?
I believe, yeah. I think Henson's kid took over the company, one of them.
Okay, yeah. I mean, they're still, I mean, what? Tickle Me Elmo? Now, I know it's been a few years since then, but That was the largest toy at Christmas time 1 year.
I've always been around the mantle. I don't know what the hell.
I know something gayer than that, Shadowhawk.
Oh, well, I'm not saying gay. That's just totally wrong.
Well, Barney. Barney was, oh my God. I mean, kill me now.
Barney was horrible.
Barney was horrible, and my kids watched that. I thought, what the? At least I had Mr. Rogers.
Dude, I got really lucky. My oldest daughter didn't like Barney. So.
There was good programming when I grew up, when you and I grew up, Shadow, and when Elsie grew up.
We had good cartoons.
But, I mean, they get Barney. They get Teletubbies. What the hell?
Dude, there's no Saturday morning cartoons anymore. Like on regular TV.
In fact, the X-Men on Fox was kind of like the end of it. There's a great documentary on YouTube about, you know, whatever happened to the Saturday morning. Yeah, and they'll give you the reasons behind it. I blame one big thing that really impacted was Ted Kennedy's legislation, especially for the 70s. It killed all the great cartoons of the 60s.
Yeah, it did pretty well screw all the good ones.
It did, yeah. I don't think it was ultra violent, but I mean, Johnny Quest, my God, people died in all kinds of ways.
You couldn't get away with that today. No way.
You got a gun. You're a hater. Oh, well, but dude, Elmo doing a hand puppet, and he was a sexual offender. Remember when that news came out?
Think about all the strikes nowadays that Johnny Quest has. They got violence with young kids involved, right? They've got a suspect relationship between the dad and his bodyguard, and then they've got a kid they randomly kidnapped named Haji. What the hell? Fuck, people would freak out today, dude.
Oh, I do too, Caleb, but you didn't have to go to school, and I have a picture of myself shirtless, just in like shorts, in front of the TV, watching Saturday morning TV and my homemade comic there on the carpet. He just got to do it. It's compulsory. Otherwise, he just can't, you know, doesn't. Oh, okay. Oh, that is part of the comic. No, that's not part of the. Don't! Wait, I hit the wrong button.
Hey, LG.
That was a Homer Simpson, wasn't it?
No, it was a Bert and Ernie.
Oh, Bert and Ernie, right. Yeah, they do have Bert and Ernie Pez. Really, they have a big Bert Pez. They have crystal heads, which are like clear plastic. Rubber ducky, you're the one. You make about time so much fun. Rubber ducky, you're the one for me. I took an early ferry. Hey, hey, good looking. What? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, they got an animal too from the Muppets. Remember Animal?
Oh, I loved Animal. He was my favorite Muppet.
He was my favorite Muppet, yeah.
We're going bowling. That's not dangerous. It is when Animal bowls.
Being green. Dave's smiling over there. It's not easy being green. Yeah, there's Elmo. Yeah, they got an Elmo too. They got the little girl Muppet too. There's quite a few Muppets. Look at that. Is that a Muppet? That's probably more than that.
Growling baggy. Oh.
Oh, there we go. Hulk smash.
That looks like a crotch crusher.
Crotch crusher.
Yeah. That's my next.
So Dave
book
gives you the butt out. Shot. There you go, Kerry.
But you said butt.
You said butt. Glutinous.
I've got some butts for you. Want to see some butts? I'll show you some butts. Oh, in the news, absolutely. Stormy Knight is in. The books are in. One Stormy Knight, Jason Bascom's book.
Oh, that's awesome, Caleb. I got to drop a link for that thing.
Russ Leach's book, 103 backers, $4,966. He's getting ready to hit $5,000. Why can't that be me?
Wait, which that is a Jawbone Dev? Is that, have I got the right one?
Damn it. Russ Leach? That's the Cole book over on Find My Comic.
Oh, okay.
Oh, and
yeah,
I have
yeah.
news on that front. It's not confirmed yet, but Luke Stone wants me to make me an ambassador for Find My Comic.
Oh my, an ambassador.
An ambassador. So, you know, Michael Bancroft's not the only one. Not the only one.
There can be only one. You and Bancroft must battle to the death.
There can be more than one. But
no,
now,
there can be only one.
I'll just agree to disagree. I love you, Shadowhawk. 56 years ago, this was on TV.
The tail.
And I kicked it. There we go. Okay. Yeah. Let's do it.
Oh God.
I have played.
Incoming ICBM.
The monkeys.
Well, we'll see everybody over on Shadowhawk Talk channel tomorrow.
No.
We used to watch that.
Now, this was absolutely one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah. I used to love this show. The Monkey Mobile.
What did you like about it, though?
Everything. I like the music. I thought they were goofy. They were funny. And I mean, I was little when I was watching these guys. I was probably I don't know, 8 or 9, something like that.
Bro, I watched it when it originally aired.
So did I.
Well, I was watching reruns, bro. I'm younger.
You're older than me, Dave. I mean, you know, you got to see that.
It was on later. It was on later over here, don't forget, because it came from America. We didn't get a lot of American stuff.
Okay.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
Can you say stuff again?
Stuff.
Okay. Now, when you say it like that, it doesn't sound British. It sounds like your roots from Scotland. Is that the way they would say stuff?
The accent, stuff, like that.
Stuff
it. Do you think you have a Scottish accent?
Only slightly.
Only slightly. And when did you leave Scotland? Very young, right?
1969, Rex.
Oh, really? You were in Scotland that long? Okay, I did not realize that.
That long. Hey, I'm not that old.
Yeah, you're Methuselah. Anyway,
damn.
The good.
Dave, I meant to ask you while we were talking about the monkeys. So was Davy Jones like already like popular in England before the monkeys started over here?
I don't really recall. I must admit.
I don't think we got the Goodlies over here.
You mean the goodies? The goodies.
Goodies. Okay, like the power.
Goodies.
The
goodies. I don't think we don't remember those. The Goonies. Yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah. The Goonies was a film, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But the Goonies was a British TV comedy series.
Junk.
Kerry says, it's so nice to hear you laugh, Shohawk. After a few days of being tired and not 100%, makes my heart smile hearing you laugh again, Shohawk.
Oh, thank you, dear. Trust me, I feel 100% better than I did yesterday.
You sound, you know, I would ask Shadowhawk a question and it would be like.
Bro, my brain was not, I mean, it was.
It wasn't functioning, was it?
I was on cruise control the last couple of days, man. I was just dehydrated.
It's like,
just
why did you?
No sleep, you know, just cheese. I was a zombie.
Are you cut? I mean, you know. Happy birthday to Jose Luis Garcia Lopez. It's his birthday today. He did Superman, Batman, Dead Man, DC Comics Presents, Jonah Hex, Tarzan, Atari Force, which you really ought to read, Superman versus Wonder Woman, and Batman versus the Incredible Hulk artist. And the
I said, I actually read a couple of Atari Force back in the day. I didn't know that was him.
Oh, did you? Yeah, that
I think I only ever read one of those, you know.
And I can even remember where I first saw it and picked it up on a monthly basis to read Shuttlehawk. It was that Fred's. I don't know if you ever knew Fred's when you were in the South in Texas, but
no.
Fred's went out a few years of bankrupt just like a year or two ago. It's been around a long time. But when I think Atari Force, I think of Fred's. I forgot they had a spinner rack right when you came in. The sliding doors. They had a spinner rack.
Fred's must not have been big in Houston.
That was early 80s. Oh, here you go. Janet from another planet. Look at this vintage Star Trek. Look how big that model was.
Yeah, I've seen that picture.
Damn. That's cool. Man, you imagine having a nice, like, man cave and just hanging that bad boy from your ceiling?
Oh, yeah. It's probably lighting in the Smithsonian. I think it's in the Smithsonian right now.
That would be so cool.
Yeah.
I'd have to put, like, a green screen up on the ceiling behind it so I could project space and shit.
Nosferatu has been fulfilling Chef and Jetty's book.
Nosferatu.
Okay, well, I'm just going to kick.
And it is absolutely beautiful. Chef is an amazing artist.
Yeah, but not to do a comparison, but beautiful. Mine's bigger, or will be when it comes out. I mean, you get a bookmark and two trading cards. Woohoo!
That's good.
What? I mean, I listed today on X what you would be getting with Devil Flyer. It was like six or seven eight different things already. Sadly, Ron Harper from Garrison's Gorillas. I used to watch that. He died. He passed away.
He did.
Ron Harper was on Land of the Lost. He was like Uncle whatever Buck or Uncle Ron.
The name is familiar, but I don't know what.
He was on Planet of the Apes.
Yeah, the TV series.
Venomous, Nightman. There he is in front, the blonde haired guy.
All right, hold on. Let me blow this up. Oh yeah, I know that dude.
Yeah, Ron Harper. He was on the Gorillas. Yeah.
Okay.
He was on the TV show.
Is that Roddy McDowell in the makeup behind
him? Yeah, he was in the TV show.
No shit. Yeah, look at that.
Yep. About 1975 on TV.
Yeah, I was watching this when I was little, man. I was like 8 or 9.
I've got all the episodes on DVD. Surprise, surprise, Shadow.
I do. Yeah, shocking, dude. And I even have the animated.
I've got them as well.
He was in 87.
I will show you the animated.
He was in 80. Okay, I think we're getting some feedback somewhere.
All right, I'm going to pop out and come back.
Wait a minute. Let me mute. Let me mute as then see. Well, I don't know.
Bounce out, Rex. I got to roll. I'll talk
to you. Okay, Elsie. Thank you.
See you, Elsie.
Take care, bro.
See you.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, I still heard the echo, so it was definitely on Elsie's side. Shadow kicks himself. Anyway, Ron Harper, you might not have known this. He goes way back, 87th Precinct, Wendy and Me, the Gene Arthur Show, Garrison's Gorillas. I remember they actually did a Dale comic book of that. And I have it, although it's not in very good shape. Here's a young Ron Harper. Take a look at this picture. Young, early 60s, maybe late 50s there. Yeah. Probably back in the 50s. That was probably a 50s shot, actually. But yeah, he's not known, but people should know him from Planet of the Apes, absolutely. Probably the Garrison's Gorillas. That was a great show too. Tomorrow I will be on with Dojo Coon on Incendiary, and then on Thursday I will be. Oh, I wanted to mention this too to you, Dave. The second Doctor, Patrick Troughton. It was his birthday yesterday.
Oh, was it?
He was born in 1920.
Right.
And come Thursday, he dies. Mm. Right after his last birthday, Patrick Troughton died on the 28th of March.
Right.
Right after his birthday. So he got to see one more birthday, and then he passed away 3 days later. Oh, and today, happy Spock Day. It's Leonard Nimoy's heavenly birthday today.
Is it?
Yes, indeed.
Hello, I'm surprised Janet
didn't mention
Shadow that. Is back.
What happened to Ellie?
Huh?
What happened to Ellis?
He had to go. He had to go. Oh. And the Echo was on his end.
I think there was a bit of feedback on Elsie's side, maybe.
It was on Elsie's side, yeah. So, Shadowhawk, I love to, I mean.
That's all right. I might as well pop out every once in a while anyway, because otherwise it will start to happen on my
starts
end.
Doing that, right. All right, Lorenzo, where are you at, mister?
Where's he been lately?
Can you believe he did a freaking 11-hour stream last Thursday?
Did he?
Damn. Yeah, I popped in at like 6 hours. Maybe
he's probably still recovering, right, Scott? Poor Lorenzo, dude.
No, he was in our chat the next day. I was like, what are you, you know? Anyway, here's a great shot of Slee Stacks from the land
just
of the
a
lost.
Little Slee Stack.
I remember going to IGA. Do you know IGA, the grocery?
No.
Actually, only because we have them in southern Indiana where I used to camp.
I think they're still around. There's a few IGAs still around, I think.
Yeah, it's kind of like almost like a general store. It's a grocery store, but then they sell clothes and stuff too.
Through school, through Scholastic News, maybe before I started subscribing. It was before I started. But Dynamite magazine. In fact, I could do a search and it would probably bring up some covers to some Dynamites. Dynamite magazine number 14 had the two Slee Stacks on it. And I bought it at that grocery.
No, that's not Dynamite. Like,
and I've still got it. I've still got it. All my Dynamite magazines didn't burn up in my fire.
Now, is that the same Dynamite company that's still going now that does comic?
No, that was just the title, like Bananas, Smash.
Okay, yeah.
But they often had photo covers. In fact, most of them, well, I can't say most, but, you know, sometimes they would have illustrated, you know, covers. Let me do a search for Dynamite here. This is hilarious, though. They look very frog-like here with their mouths open. This has to be from the movie that came out a few years ago, right?
Maybe. I didn't know.
They look
came
more
out
realistic. They look more realistic.
Oh yeah, that's right. What you gonna call it? Will Ferrell.
Will Ferrell.
Yeah.
And you got a Chaka. You got a Chaka monkey boy. Every time he showed up in that movie, he wanted to hump your leg. What the hell? Why does shat on my childhood?
Yeah.
What
is anyway,
by the way, Rex, I was just going to say this weekend I finally catch up with your time, back to my time.
Now, when do you convert over?
This Saturday.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So right before Easter Sunday, you change your time. Is it like that every year?
It is for the time change, but Easter is a bit earlier this year than it was last year, because last year it was in April.
So welcome back from the future early.
So I shall be back to your time. After
now, don't you start that finity goobity gob. ain't got time for a co-host that sounds like Infinity.
Oh, we're going there now. Are we? All right, mister.
He got kicked off YouTube recently, I'm told. Look at that. Yes, got kicked off. Night, I will be on with Dojo Coon and Fantic McNasty, among others. Why keep streaming is the subject.
Mm.
Why keep streaming?
Good question.
What? Why keep streaming is what we will be talking about along with Devil Flyer.
That's a nice. Well, you gotta have something that's. You want a good debate, right? You gotta have a good, solid. One way or the other.
Well, I stream a lot, so maybe that's why they came up with that.
Maybe, Rex.
Yeah, maybe it's all your fault.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm leaving.
That woke stuff's starting to rub off on me. I get hurt very easily.
I noticed. You're starting to get a little
Gene
cranky.
Gene Shalit turns 98 yesterday. Gene Shalit, remember him?
No.
I mean, yes. He had the hair like Don King almost.
He was a one-trick fucking pony, and he's stupid. So,
well, he's a liberal. Oh, did I say that out loud?
Most British people are liberal. Would you like to see a couple of trading cards, Rex?
Would you say that, Dave, that most people, that most Britishers are more liberal than the conservative Americans?
Probably.
Yeah. Oh, that kind of looks like a female Manable character. Remember Manable?
Tigra.
Yeah. Now, see, I would like to see Tigra in the Marvel Universe in the movies if they would do her right.
If they did her right, well, I would love to see She-Hulk if they did it right too, but they're not going to. So, yeah.
Right. They already tried the She-Hulk thing and ruined that brand. Thank you very
much. Yeah, they destroyed that with the fucking horrible TV show.
That looks like a promo card for Here to Eternity.
It kind of does, doesn't it?
Yeah. Remember with them the water washing up over the beach over Burt Lancaster and
sexy with all that seaweed wrapping around you.
Yeah. Remember speaking of seaweed. Remember Sigmund?
Yeah, Sigmund and the Sea Monsters. Yeah, hell yeah, those Croft Super Shows. That. Man. Oh, that's cool. I like that one.
Good out there.
Yeah. Who's this, Dan?
Okay, he just holds it up to the camera. He can't read.
Okay, so it's from
Jim Warren, Surrealism. I was going to say it looks a little surrealistic.
Yeah.
So is it all Jim Warren artwork?
Yeah, it's a full set of cards. These
traveling,
are
the ones I've got. Traveling Woman is the name of
this. Damn, that's cool, man.
Yeah.
They're quite good, aren't they?
Yeah, very nice. Look at that. Wow.
It looks almost like, even though her hand's not up there, the waterfall almost looks like a curved knife. I cut you!
It does. That's what I thought it was like a scimitar at first.
Yeah. I cut
That's
you.
That's wild. That's nice, man. I've never heard of this guy. Very cool.
You not heard of Shalit? Really?
No, Jesus.
Oh. What a face, man.
Do you have to show me that? That dude should have been born a Muppet.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, he turned 98. Cool. He's still alive, 98 years old.
Hold on, look at this. Look at how beautifully this guy blended this face into a landscape.
I'm not really impressed.
I like it. I think the eyes are a little close together.
It looks like surrealism commercialized to me.
Alrighty then.
I'd much rather go to a museum and look at some real.
I think these are artwork. Pretty cool.
Oh, they're nice, high end production. It's just like, yeah, that looks airbrush.
So, What, you got something against an airbrush now?
Still nice.
No, though. Not necessarily, but I'm just saying it looks at like least it's not art.
At least it's not fucking AI.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
I mean, nice, nowadays.
Man. They are nice. They are nice. I'm just not overly impressed by them.
Hmm. I just thought I'd show you those few because I've got like a full set of them.
When did you get I like you had them, those, Dave, for a while?
Boy. Yeah, I bought these back when they came out, back in 1993.
Oh, 93. Wow. Okay. Mm. So you've had them for like over 30 years.
Amazing. I have. Yeah.
With the box. Yeah, right, I don't kinda, know how this is going to play.
It kind of reminded me, Dave, of like the old Boris Vallejo or Julie Strain stuff, you know, that kind of art from back in the early 90s.
Yeah. I've actually got a Boris set as well, Shadow.
Yeah. Oh, dude, I had a Boris sticker set that I got, and I had a black base at the time. Mm-hmm. So I took all the coolest ones out of the set, and I put them all over the base. And then I clear coated them on there so that they were there permanently.
Mm.
It was the coolest thing, dude.
I mean, I must admit, there's some nice sets of trading cards when you look around.
Yeah, I don't know if you remember, and Boris did a, I think it was like 91 or 92. They did a set of, it was like trading cards, but they were all stickers.
Oh, I don't think I saw them.
Dave, yeah, do you have any of these Corgi Juniors that came out? It seems like I used to have the Supermobile and maybe the Superman van. I think you could look in. I know I'm pretty sure.
I don't remember them.
Yeah, you got Tom and Jerry and Popeye and Olive Oil.
I'm pretty sure I had that Superman one in the middle with the like little punchy hands on it or whatever.
I think that was also in I think that was seen in one or two Superman comics as well, wasn't it, Shadow?
Yes,
I think
it was.
It may have been, yeah.
And Garcia Lopez, it's his birthday today. He actually drew that in some of those comics. It was really cool.
Is he still around? Is Garcia Lopez still?
Oh yeah, it's his birthday today. He's still around. He's still producing.
Well, you do birthdays all the time for people that are dead, dude.
Okay, yeah, he's still around. He does a lot of their marketing and has.
Sometimes you are so obtuse, my friend.
Ooh, I haven't heard that word in a while.
Yeah, and you make me have to say it.
I know I had a Superman and Hulk. I think I had a Superman too. You could look in the back of the van and it would have a little scene that you could see in the van.
Oh, I think you're right. I remember that. It had like a little window in there you could poke your eye.
Kind of like Viewmaster, except it was the same scene all the time.
Yeah, it didn't change. And it was, a horrible.
Yesterday in 1954, the first mass-produced color TV was introduced by RCA. The cost was $1,000 with a screen 11 and a half inches wide. RCA owned NBC color casting in 1953. Unlike CBS's earlier color efforts, these compatible broadcasts were also viewable on black and white sets. The early CBS stuff colors, look at that, 11 and a half inches.
Is that 1954, Rex?
Yes.
Hey, my year.
$1,000. I wonder what that would be in today's money. Quite expensive, actually.
Yeah.
Probably like when the big screen TVs came out, they were over $1,000. They were over a couple thousand dollars.
Yeah, they were.
Now you can get larger than a 50-inch screen. You can get 70-something for about $400.
I've got a 65-inch screen myself.
Of course, they're made in China.
Oh, my screen's bigger. I got like a little 32-inch one. That's all I need.
It took 60 years.
I went
Dude,
for
if I put a 65-inch TV in my living room, it would be like a good two-thirds of one wall.
Have you seen this movie, Sergeant Deadhead, the astronaut, that had Cesar Romero, Frankie Valli, and others in it?
Never even. I don't believe so.
It even had Buster Keaton in it. Never He's down there, too. Mm-hmm. Urgent, top secret, and absolutely hilarious. Sergeant Deadhead, the astronaut. I don't know if I've seen that or not.
I know I have.
Looks like a good one. An astronaut goes into space with a chimpanzee. I bet it was Frankie Valli. He's the astronaut. When they return to Earth after their orbit, it is discovered that the chimp has the brains of the astronaut, and the astronaut has the brains of the chimp.
Planet of the Apes, all over again.
Come back, say, you blow it up, blow it up. By the way,
Shadow, I was just going to tell you, I've ordered myself another book on Bernie Wrightson.
Oh, really? What'd you get? So,
I can't remember the title at the minute, but it should be arriving sometime in the next couple of weeks from America.
Dude, if you get a chance, go back and watch. I think it was last night. I was on with Elsie for a minute. I could be wrong, though, because I've been pretty out of my head the last few days.
It wasn't last night because we had Mike Barron on.
We were backstage. That's right. Dave won't be able. But Elsie pulled out a bunch of Bernie Wrightson like signed stuff, like just cool books, man. I was like, I wasn't even aware of them because they came out in like 2012 or something. I wasn't.
Yeah, well, I just found out about this particular book that I've ordered. I'll just check and see what it's called. I can't remember. But it's not arrived yet. I'm still waiting for it.
Guys, if I say the name, the actor's name, John, hopefully I'll get this right. Kolakos. Do you know who that is?
John Kolakos.
C-O-L-I-C-O-S.
C-O-L-A-C-O-S? Kolakos. That sounds right. Kolakos.
Uh-huh. He started as the Klingon Corps. John also played the villain Baltar on Battlestar Galactica. He played the evil judge Flood, the last person to be killed on Gunsmoke in the episode Hard Labor. The final show was filmed but aired out of order by NBC. So he was the last. Wait a minute.
Sorry, Dave.
It's all right.
There's a picture. Sorry, Dave.
Oh, I recognize him. I had no idea what his name was.
Yeah, there he is as Baltar on the Battlestar Galactica.
John Kolakos, isn't it?
Kolakos? Okay.
Yep. Dave's right.
Dave's probably right. Okay. He was the last person killed on Gunsmoke. I didn't know that.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, did they like change the rules or something? You couldn't kill people on TV no more or something?
No. It was just that after, you know, he was just the last person killed.
Yeah.
I mean, they canceled it after a while. After like 20 seasons.
So he just happened to be. All right. Dave is trying to show me something and I can't see it. It's tiny.
Okay.
Have to make it bigger.
Let me blow this up. Ooh.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, yeah. That's where he's coming out of the ground.
Bernie Wrightson. Trees?
Bernie Wrightson. It says Bernie Wrightson. Yeah, that's a famous piece by him of Swamp Thing. He just won't read it. He just shows it. You drive me crazy.
The FPG years.
Oh, the FPG years. Okay.
There you go.
What's the
FPG years? I couldn't read the. Okay, now it's coming in.
I can't read it either, and I'm looking, and I've got good eyesight. I just can't. Yeah. What's the FPG?
I don't know. What's FPG?
I don't know.
He doesn't know, but he, you know, throws it out there. He's all curious. But
I've bought it.
I love it. Oh, fucking dude. Check this out. What is it? I have no idea.
I know, right? And this doesn't seem to correlate. Anyway, we need some more lizard representation.
It's actually the publisher is FPG, by the way.
Okay, there,
there
you
is
go.
There's not enough room in that publisher.
Deep. Now we know. I hate that. Here we go. Another commercial.
Not waking the cat up.
Godzilla's actually pretty cool, except when he's hungry.
Snickers satisfies. See the new Godzilla in theaters May 16th. And that's why Godzilla will always be better than King Kong.
Thank you for joining us.
So that's a book to look forward to soon.
It's been a hopefully good run. Almost 700 episodes. Kong rules. That's why the Kong King.
Yeah, it should be a nice book, Shadow, when it arrives, I think.
Yeah, dude, I can't wait to see this one. Looks intriguing.
That's what I thought. I've no idea what it's like inside, because obviously you can't see inside it. But
right, Shadowhog,
favorite Godzilla movie of all time.
It's Bernie Grayson, dude.
Yeah.
Huh? Favorite Godzilla movie of all time, if you could only have
one. Destroy All Monsters, hands down.
Okay. Destroy All Monsters. I'll have to watch that one. Here is a poster going up against King Ghidorah in 1991. Hope I said that right.
Ghidorah.
I bring up Godzilla and you don't even do the. I swear I'm going to get Godzuki.
What am I? You're dancing monkey on a stick.
I'm going to get Godzuki in here to co-host, I swear. That's the movie poster illustrated and framed by Nira Yoshiyori.
Yeah, that guy.
I don't know. After saying that, I just feel like I'm just going to let that one lie there.
Is that the Incredible Shrinking Man by any chance?
That was incredible.
That's got to be fun for one of them anyway.
For him, it was like spelunking.
Did you watch Francis Ford Coppola's The Outsiders?
Nobody gets my joke.
Nobody wants to. Oh, okay. Did you watch The Outsiders 1993, Francis Ford Coppola? I didn't.
Unfortunately, yes, I did.
You did?
Never heard of that one.
What is that movie about?
It was terrible. It was actually, do you not remember The Outsiders, the book from back in the day? It was like when you were in junior high school, like everybody read it. You had Pony Boy and Soda Pop and all these stupid fucking nicknamed idiots. Supposed to be like a bunch of Brooklyn kids, you know, trying to be tough guys in a gang. One of them ends up getting killed in a street fight, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. It's a bunch of crap.
54 years ago, Hendrix's album here, put that under a black light. That would be pretty cool.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I got a black light Jimi Hendrix poster up in my stream room whenever I finally get it put together. Nope, not in the hallway. It's in the actual stream.
Band of Gypsies, 54 years ago, 1970. Rick Springfield. I could have met him. I didn't. I could have met him though.
Okay. Rick Springfield. And everybody can hate on me if they want to, but
General Hospital. The
Jimi Hendrix and the Experience is a thousand times better than Jimi Hendrix Band of Gypsies. I'm sorry, but it's fucking true.
I'm going to the cheese room.
I've suddenly got this need for some cheese. I don't know why.
Wouldn't that be like Jerry's house on Tom and Jerry?
Yeah, no shit. What the hell?
I don't know. If you put a, if you,
what is this, like one of those wacky hotels or something?
You know, somebody should do a spoof on Doctor Who, put a TARDIS, and then have those walls. Because Doctor Who had those oval walls, remember?
I think somebody did that in the UK. They built a room like,
you know, with a little modification, those could almost be like the honeycomb structures that Ethan puts in the background. Ooh, of,
that would be Gouda.
I cheese what you did there, and I mean, see what you did there.
The is it the Thames? A Thames, the Thames, right?
Thames, isn't it?
The Thames. Thames.
They've been doing some promotion. Speaking of Godzilla and Kong, have you seen this, Dave? At the Thames, they've actually got a little thing here. See, Godzilla floats in the water. Not sure about the pink and purplish, you know. And then they've got a Kong.
Why did they make Godzilla gay?
They've got a Kong hand with a mock-up phone.
Yeah, an old phone
box. And look at that. Kong coming out of the ground. You need to go check that out. They've got that up right now, I believe.
It's too far.
Kong, the New Empire in cinemas March 29th. Wow, that's Friday.
I still have not seen any good reason why Godzilla suddenly turned pink
this week.
I don't either. I don't understand unless it's part of the story.
It's going to be part of the story, but is it going to be some bullshit just, you know, levered in there for whatever reason?
Speaking of levering, I promised you some fat ass. Here we go.
Whoa. Woo. Damn.
Can I curl you?
That's a load.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Like, I curl you. I pick you up and, like, get a pump.
Okay, you
want to
try?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Okay.
Oh, don't worry.
Oh, God.
I mean, she's nearly naked.
Okay, yeah. I'm heavy. I'm a little heavy, right? I'm a little heavy.
All the way to that sexy ass.
Not, she's not heavy. As big as the first girl.
There we go.
Woo! Okay.
No, she was your way in the first one.
How much weight's in that ass? Should I try?
Okay.
Holy shit, where do I grab this one? I don't even know where to fucking start. Holy shit, I gotta warm up these biceps or some shit. How much you weigh?
Oh my God. Yeah, she didn't tell her.
Damn.
This is a PR.
Yeah.
This is a PR.
Yeah, that's a lot of booty.
That's a lot of booty. Well, you know, back it up here. Look at this first chick.
Back it up, Rex. I see what you did.
Look at the first chick.
That was a big ass booty, too, man. Don't get me wrong.
That was big-ass booty. The very first one was the largest.
That ought to have some flashing lights and a wide load sign on it.
Beep, beep, beep. Wiggle, wiggle, rip-off. Can I curl you? Would you do that, Dave? Would you go to the beach and curl some fat ass?
I don't think I'd be able to lift somebody that heavy.
I'd go to the beach and curl a cutie, but not one of those.
Do you guys know who Charles Harrelson was?
Don't think so.
Charles Harrelson.
not ringing any bells.
Well, that's Woody Harrelson's father. He was a notorious hit. He was a notorious hitman. He received a life sentence for the murder of a federal judge in 1979. Additionally, he repeatedly asserted that he was the real assassin behind the killing of John F. Kennedy.
Wow.
How about that?
That's wild, dude. I never heard that one before.
Mm-hmm. So I guess he's still in prison unless he's dead. Which he's
Woody dead. Harrelson's kind of a nutbag, man.
Yeah. Yeah,
well, now I understand, you know, why. There she is, the return of Maya.
Yeah.
What do you guys think about the sequel to Westworld, Future World?
It was all right, but Westworld was way scarier.
Yeah. I think the first film was the best.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
I saw Westworld when I was pretty young, dude. And Yul Brynner just scared the shit out of me.
Yeah. He was a very good actor in that part, wasn't he?
Yeah, dude, he was like the original Terminator, you know?
Yeah,
I can't remember. Was he in this movie here?
I think they did bring him back into the...
I think they brought him back for it, yeah.
I think he was in it.
There's the old robot that had no face, that played cards and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love that character. He was cool. I thought he was destroyed in the first movie, but I can't remember.
Yeah, they actually, Westworld, the HBO series, that first season started off really good, man. And then I don't know what happened. It just fell apart.
Mm.
You'll have to blow this up, Shadowhawk.
All right, hold on.
Can you tell me what this ensemble, bum, 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 bum. Ensemble represent? That's Floyd the barber on the left. The actor in the middle, I believe, is the guy that played Mannix. Remember Mannix? That's him, yeah.
No, that ain't him.
Yeah, it is. This is back in the 50s.
Dude, why is he fatter then than he was in the 70s? Okay, maybe he lost weight.
Yeah.
The dude on the right looks very familiar.
Almost looks like Charlton Heston, but yeah, that's I forget the actor's name, but yeah, he did a lot of stuff. The only really identify the is brat? The lady. Huh?
I said, who's the brat?
I don't know. She's the only one that I don't even recognize.
Hmm.
I guess Floyd the barber from Mayberry plays the doctor on Gunsmoke. This is the radio ensemble, the voices to Gunsmoke on the radio.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense.
Yeah, the doc.
When you were saying that one dude is fucking, what's his name?
Like, the guy from Mannix. That's him. Yep. Or no. Is it Mannix? He had that deep voice. I can't.
No, that's Cannon.
He was a big guy.
He ended up getting fatter. Yeah.
Yes.
He was called Frank.
The guy from Cannon. You are correct.
Yeah.
Well, you win Mannix was like
the stony face looking dude. He had like that kind of rough face and the dark hair.
Hey, Rob. He says, oh, heck, I'm very late.
Hey, Rob. What's up? Oh, man, you missed so much.
Well, Ron Harper passed away. He used to be on Planet of the Apes and Garrison's. Today would have been, the 23rd would have been David Bacon. You're not going to remember his name. David Bacon's birthday. He was born in 1914. Remembered for his role as the masked Marvel in 1943. Age 29, seen as he stumbled from his car and wearing only a swimsuit, he died having been stabbed through his back. His murder remains unsolved.
Wow.
So if you're a movie serial buff like I am, 1943's.
So somebody stabbed this guy in the back and nobody ever figured out who it was?
Nobody figured out who murdered him. Yeah, he stumbled out of his car, only in a bathing suit, stabbed in the back.
That's fucked up.
That's messed up, yeah.
Sorry.
Here he is in a few scenes, the masked marvel with his mask off. He was a handsome guy. It was probably over a lady.
How old was he? That's still pretty young, I'm guessing, when he died, right?
Oh, yeah, man. He was 29 years old.
Damn. Yeah, I guarantee you, dude, it was somebody jelly go over a girl.
Mm-hmm. Not that anybody cares, but it was Elton John's birthday yesterday.
But you know what? That's what happens when you go playing in somebody else's pool.
Right. Now, yesterday was Paul Michael
You know that
Gleiser's
pool is
birthday.
Occupied. You leave it alone.
Paul Michael Gleiser's birthday yesterday. He's 81 years old. Hey, Jack, now.
Really? Is he still alive? I thought he died years ago.
No, he's still alive. He was in the Starsky and Hutch remake of the movie a few years ago.
Yeah, I remember that.
I think he's alive.
But he had, he got AIDS from, he gave his blood transfusion from his wife. There was some weird shit, but he ended up getting AIDS. Or his wife had AIDS from a blood transfusion or some shit. There's a whole big thing about it back in the late 80s.
This says he's 81 years young.
Wow. Amazing. Yeah. So David Soul's gone and he's still here. Okay.
Yeah, David Soul's gone. Yeah.
Don't give up on us, baby.
This was an interesting comparison they did with Hollywood. Jack Nye says, howdy, boys. Good to see you feeling better, Shadowhawk.
Thanks, Jack. Nice to see you.
Didn't Alfalfa get stabbed?
No shit. Man.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, he did get stabbed with a big hunting knife, I believe. Yeah.
Yeah, I think he was kind of doing
his blood with AIDS. Was, there you go.
He was doing the same thing, too, I think, though. Alfalfa was, you know, he got caught messing with someone else's woman.
You will never hear about this, Texas Dave. So I'll tell you, you know, in the local news here statewide in Arkansas, there was a guy tied to the Bill Clinton. The FBI was Bill Clinton Foundation, and the guy was in a shootout a couple of days ago with the police, shot to death. I think he killed an officer, too. I'm not sure, but he was in a shootout. They were going to raid his home. Something like that. They were getting a little too close, and the Clintons like, yeah, take one for the team, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Oh, dude, you want to hear the craziest thing I heard today? With all the bridge collapse and everything else that's going on. The crazy winds last night knocked over a fence here in Indiana.
Hey, guys. All
right, well, never mind.
No, I'm listening. I just want to say hi to Caroline. She says I can't sleep.
Oh, hey, Caroline. Anyway, so a fence gets blown down. A whole herd of cows gets loose. Mm-hmm. Now, just in this incident, there were at least 7 to 8 cows involved, okay? How does someone driving down the road, I don't care what time of day or night or whatever the fuck it is, not see a herd of cows on the road in front of you? This guy ran into the herd and like took out 7 or 8 cows. They're not telling anybody how many died. And then local firefighters had to lead the rest of the herd back to the farm. Well, I mean, how do you not see a herd of cows?
Yeah.
I don't know. This has a gun smoke vibe to it. Here lies George Johnson, hanged by mistake in 1882. And the bottom part of the marker says he was wrong.
He was right. We was wrong.
We was wrong. But we strung him up and now he's gone.
Damn.
Yeah. Didn't help him much. Poor George.
That's pretty cold, man.
That's cold. Yeah. I mean, mocking him Damn. After they hung him by mistake.
Yeah, just come over there and pee on it while you're at it.
Well, just for that comment, Dang. There you go, Shadow Hawk. Just for that comment.
Oh, God.
Still got the hair.
That asshole's still alive? Jesus.
Yeah, he's alive. He's 90, what I say, 98 years old.
Oh, good God, man.
Yeah.
Only the good guy.
I totally forgot about him, but once you see him, you can't unsee him. You know what I mean?
Dude, he's like the evil professor from some video game.
Gotta get back in time. Like,
I feel like I'm Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm like, every time I see that.
He does look like Sonic the Hedgehog, doesn't he? Wow.
Dr. Eggbeater, whatever his name was.
What was he known for? You don't know.
He was a movie critic.
Movie critic, right. Whoa. Still got the bow tie.
God bless. Jeez. Yeah. Neither one of them's better. They're both absolutely horrible.
He was God. A movie critic in like the 70s and 80s, right?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. Maybe early 90s. I'm not sure.
Yeah, he turned 98 years old. Check this bling out. An incredible collection of 54 ancient rings collected by a gas engineer from Lancashire. Then stored away is to go under the hammer. Died at the age of 93 in 2003. Yeah, he kept it secret, probably, because he didn't want to get it taken away from him. Rings cover eras from Alexander the Great to the Middle Ages via the height of the Roman Empire. Included, let's see, where am I at here? Included Greek, Roman, Byzantine, Viking, and medieval. For example, a golden ring from Hellenistic East Greek period of the 4th through the 1st century BC. One has cabochon grenades, one with four stones looking like a bee with wings, or a gold ring from the 2nd century AD with a carnelian bust of Viva Saba, wife of Emperor Hadrian. Wow.
It's carnelian, but yeah.
Okay, I'm murdering this. Anyway, there's look at this. It's going to go up under the hammer there. Those rings, man, that's got to be worth a fortune, especially the, you know, as old as they are. I mean, the newest one is from the Middle Ages. Some of them go back before Christ. How do you accumulate a collection like that?
The crazy part is they all look like fucking costume jewelry.
Mm. I don't know. It looks pretty real to me. I mean,
a couple of those emeralds might, but I mean, if I saw
all
somebody,
that and no mood ring, no 70s mood ring, what the hell? I like the garnet stones, of course. Garnet's my favorite. I should get a big old garnet, you know.
I like jade.
Ooh, Mike Blue. You want some Mike Blue? Here you go.
Sapphire.
Mike Blue. Love Black Pluke.
Oh, there you go.
This is called the Reluctant Bride, but she doesn't seem too reluctant to me.
Whoa. Man. All right, baby. Good luck.
Yeah, good. Well, I like with that. That kind of reminds me of King Kong, you know, where the women would be sacrificed. Can you tell me what game these people are playing?
I know.
You do? Pac-Man. What is it, Dave?
It's a Space Invaders.
What is
space
it?
Space Invaders.
Space Invaders? Okay. That makes sense.
No, it's generic. It's just a.
Okay. I don't think so.
Generic game. There's no.
He wouldn't have asked if it was. That was actually a question. Check out this monkey. He looks like a kung fu master. Check this monkey out. I'll make that bigger. There we go. He does look like something out of Kung Fu Panda. Kung Fu Panda was like third at the box office, doing very well. Although I hear it's not, you know. Nope. Joe Sontag's Reaper Destroyer. Have you backed this card set over on FOMI Comics, Shadowlock? Or any intention? I think that's the Iron Age. Joe Sontag's Reaper Destroyer. Unfortunately, we won't get a Billy Tucci She card. But the big news is, there's Ron Harper with the Chaka and Will on the land of the lost. You watched that, Dave, didn't you? Even though you're older.
Yeah, I did.
You did?
Yeah.
You did? I actually. Oh, we lost Shadowhunt. Yeah, Sid and Marty Croft. Now we're gonna have to talk about the third Doctor, which is you know, as you well know, who was the third Doctor?
Third Doctor was John Pertwee.
John Pertwee, and John Pertwee's son is an actor.
Yeah.
He played Alfred in Gotham. And he looks a lot like his dad. A lot like his dad. Do you know his son's name?
I can't remember off the top of my head.
Okay. Coming next, Doctor Who and the Spearhead from Space. Ooh. Which was the first John Pertwee. First Doctor Who in color. There's the Altons, right?
Yeah.
Which were mannequins that come to life. Very scary. They go around shooting people. There he is falling out of the TARDIS, if you back it up a little bit. I don't recognize his. Oh, that's his first companion. She was a pretty good looker back in the day, huh?
She was.
But she was only did one season, the first season. Ambassadors of Death was the second one, right?
Yeah.
After Spearhead from Space.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we will have to be getting our John Pertwee. Give me another week to watch some John Pertwee. And we'll do our Doctor Who greatest third Doctor countdown.
Right, so.
Yeah. I'm really surprised that even on the third Doctor, some of the stuff has been destroyed. I mean, as far as there's no color.
Yeah, there's a few like that.
Patrick Troughton, though, his birthday yesterday, he was the second Doctor before John Pertwee. He was born yesterday in 1920 and died. In 1987 on Thursday, the 28th. He was in two Ray Harryhausen movies and The Omen. Here he is in some of those. There, the Ray Harryhausen character the second time. And that's Patrick Wayne, John Wayne's son, back there playing Sinbad. There he is, skewered by the lightning rod in the omen, and then playing his recorder. Why do they call it a recorder, John? Or why do I want to call you John?
It's not okay. I don't know.
Dave?
I don't know.
Do I even know a John? Oh.
What?
I just saw this and said, ooh. And it wasn't because of Adam West.
I didn't think it was.
That cat booty, you know, that booty time, across the USA, booty time. Hey, hey, hey. Here's some great Star Trek artwork. Check this out. Leonard Nimoy's birthday today.
Excuse me.
Oh, bless you. Of course, she played what other famous character?
Not sure.
That's the second. She played Batgirl. Same actress.
Oh, of course. Yeah, Yvonne Craig.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's a Gorn in the background. Remember the Gorn? Slow-moving rubber suit Gorn? We kept going like white noise. Oh, here's another piece. It skipped one. Sulu there with the full.
Yeah.
I don't know if you heard it, but breaking news, BBC will stop using AI for Doctor Who promotionally, canceling following complaints.
Oh.
No plans to use AI again in promotion of Doctor Who. This follows complaints from viewers. The tech was used in a small trial by the BBC. Are you excited about the new Who?
I don't know yet.
Yeah. Don't know yet.
I'll probably watch it because I've watched all the others.
Yeah, I guess you got to keep the trend going. I'd rather be new.
I'll probably battle through it.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Oh, Mark Texeria. Check out this Mark Texeria piece. Venom piece.
Nice, isn't it?
Venom and Moon Knight.
Yeah, that's a combination.
I think they must have the name wrong on this. This doesn't look like Mark Texeria. It looks like that artist that did Marvel Zombies. They've got the name wrong on that. I know they do. It's that Saddam guy. Well, Dave, on April 15th, we will be launching Tome of Reckoning.
All right.
Tome of Reckoning. Here's an old 1969. Now, you mentioned 1969. There you go. And that you are 69. Getting ready to turn 70. I don't know that you can read this. It says, capture wild adoration in your Mother's Day gift of stardust lingerie. He's got a guy in a gorilla suit on a leash.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah. That's cool. 1969 ad for lingerie, stardust lingerie. Well, I know you got to get going here in a moment. I did want to show you William Shatner's birthday picture, though, with his birthday cake. He turned, 93?
Yeah, it was something like that.
Isn't that wild that his birthday is so close to Leonard Nimoy's?
It is. Yeah, they were quite close together, if I remember.
And looking at this picture, this guy is going to outlast the actor that did Sulu.
I know. I'm just thinking that.
I think he's going to live forever. He may. William Shatner may live past 100. I think he's secretly the energizing bunny, or he's been replaced by a Gorn.
Well,
in a skin suit.
There have been rumors.
There have been rumors, yeah.
Mm.
Vincent Price is Egghead. And I can't remember the guy's name in the middle, but wow, what an actor and a voice. Yeah. That played the chief in that episode. You know what? What you had to remember, Dave, is back in the 60s, a lot of these actors were alive in vaudeville.
Yeah, they were.
At the advent of everything. They had been acting. I remember that this actor in the middle, he did the voice of like the Magic Mirror from like that Disney used back in the day. Mirror, mirror, who's on the wall? Who's the greatest of them all? That, you know?
Yeah.
All right, you damn filthy humans. Bob Larkin cover. Man, I wish they would do Planet of the Apes right. I'm just not impressed by the newer Planet of the Apes. I have to tell you the lobster story one of these days. Check those lobsters out compared to that boy. Cool is the lobsters have one claw, like the rock claw, bigger than the other claw. They never stop growing.
Yeah,
they could be like 80 to 100 years old, Dave.
Yeah, they do grow big.
You know, some of those lobsters. Lobsters were considered a stigma, kind of poor food for people. There you go. There's a good Patrick Troughton montage. I would have liked to seen him in the Highlanders with the cap on. I would like a hat like that. I listened to that not too long ago a couple times. In the early days, he's always looking for a hat to wear.
That's true.
Bunch of that taken from Tele Snaps, because unfortunately a lot of the Second Doctor stuff just doesn't... That's criminal that they wipe Billy Hartnell stuff, but it's really criminal that they wipe the Second Doctor, Patch Trout and stuff. Howard Cosell. Remember Howard Cosell? His birthday was yesterday as well. Here is Patrick Troughton as John Masefield in The Box of Delights, which was a Ray Harryhausen. I don't think I've seen that one. If I have, maybe once. That's Patrick Troughton later in his career.
Cat's off probably again.
Like 70, huh?
Cat's off again, right? She's trying to tell me something.
She's roaming. Yes, feed me, feed me.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yep. They did the TARDIS in the pale green. It was filmed in black and white, but
it kind of looks all right, actually. That.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't know if he got a TARDIS upgrade. I think maybe the console changed with the Second Doctor, didn't it?
Yeah, it did slightly. Yeah, they redesigned it just a little bit. Little bit. Yeah, every new Doctor, it was slightly different, I think, if I remember
right. Slightly different, yeah, to give it a new look.
Yeah.
There he is in his hoodie. No, not a hoodie. What do you call it? A beanie.
A beanie.
That was in Fury from the Deep. Even though that doesn't exist, we have tele snaps of it. That was Fury from the Deep, which, as you know, ranked up pretty high, Dave, was the first appearance of his magic wand, the sonic screwdriver.
Screwdriver.
Well, Dave, thanks for coming on.
How's the sound?
Sound is good.
Sounded good. Okay. Real quick. I just got one thing to say, and then I'm out of here. We're well over the 2 hour mark.
We are.
Well, hang around. I'm getting ready to end it. Say your
go
thing, and then
yourself,
I'll end.
You little childish piece of shit. I don't monitor the chat fucking the entire time. So you're ranting and raving about fucking echoes. Doesn't matter. Mention it once. When I see it in the chat, I'll pop out and come back. Quit being a little fucking bitch. I'm sorry you're new, and I've been trying to be nice to you. Fuck off. Okay.
All right. One more thing, Shadowhawk. What is it?
Oh, hello. Keep collecting.
Hey, Glenn. Hey, and Glenn Fleming popping in, and Bone. Yep. I think was Bone in?
Hey,
early?
Glenn. Oh, shit. I'm sorry you had to see that, Glenn.
Bone, I hope you heard the good news. You'll be getting another card along with Shadowhawk. Yeah, so let's go.
Hell yeah.
Hey, this has been episode 698. Tomorrow, 699, and then 700. And I already have those set up.
God.
I'm sure you got the notifications.
All right, hell on, NPC. We're good, man. Give me a chance.
Just give me a chance. Give me a chance. I love it. I'm going to have to use that as a title.